对于几百万美国人来讲，关于马丁·路德·金博士和他所宣导的非暴力对抗不公的思想依然存在，并且深刻地在每个人心中。美国房屋及城市建设部部长本·卡森和政治策略人士、前民主党全国委员会主席唐拿·布拉齐尔出席了美国之音特约记者萨斯特伦的访谈节目，回忆马丁·路德·金博士对他们生活的影响，特别是当年轻的非洲裔美国人面对公然的种族歧视的时候。
I'll never forget the time in the 8th grade when they were giving out the awards for the most outstanding academic performance, and I was the only black student, and I got the award, and one of the teachers got up in front of the assembly and basically chastised the white kids. You can't let a black kid be number one. What's wrong with you?
That was a culture in which African Americans or blacks were told they had to do certain things. I went to all black schools until integration came in the 1970s.
布拉齐尔同本卡森都表示，金博士是一名有吸引力的领袖，他的智力水准同他对和平的热情互相匹配。
He studied the various empires of the world and looked at various leaders, and he was an eclectic. He took what was good from each one, amalgamated that into a very clever, a very brilliant strategy for achieving things through peace.
His dream encompassed so much more than just the American dream. It was the belief that one day our country could live up to his ideals, a dream that we could be treated as equal citizens.
講緊馬丁·路德·金對於目前國際同美國國內嘅政治風氣可能會有啲乜嘢態度呢？
Dr. King would still be telling us that we have to fight poverty and injustice in American society, and he would also call attention to war, not just between the United States and other nations, but Dr. King would call for an end of violence throughout the United States and all over the world.
I think he would be disappointed that there's a lot of identity politics going on. You know, he was saying, I long for the day when people are judged by the content of their character rather than by their external appearance. And yet, what do we have today? This group versus this group.
本卡森又说，如果马丁·路德·金依然生存的话，他终其一生宣导的相容并包的思想可能会使到他成为一种足以烧利分歧的声音。